I doubt it. Purav, get up from there. Get up. This is the last period. Never mind, I'm telling your class in charge right now. What do you people do in the class? Now here, this is, I would say, the project that you have to make. Okay, please take out your notebooks and write something. You're not here enjoying your holiday. Yes, here, page one of your report would be acknowledgement, right? Acknowledgement, yes, at your acknowledgement to your teachers and other people you want to acknowledge who have helped you in the preparation of this report, okay? Page two would be index, right? Fine. Page three would be your report. Fine. And page four would be your certificate of completion. Okay. All these have to be there in your report file. Now, when you write your report, you know how it is written. You know how the title of the report, byline, everything, format, you know of the report or not? Yes or no? Tell me. That is acknowledgement only. Thank you is acknowledgement. No, we write in the beginning only. Give your heading. Of course, we know it is you because you are submitting it. Okay, right? And then here you will write in the beginning what are the salient features. Okay, very briefly, you will just write 5 to 6 sentences. What are the important focus of change in the new education policy? Okay. So when you write the report, what is it? It's about the salient features of the report you will write down. Yes. Then here, I want you to write the report because it is so lengthy. I want you to write down that how it is going to affect you all, students of 11th and 12th. Right? Okay. And you can say curriculum or write the changes here for 11th and 12th. Right? Fine? You can talk about benefits. You can talk about its implementation. Okay. And you can give your conclusion. Right. Our main focus of the report is that how is it that this education policy has affected the curriculum of 11th and 12th. Okay, first is yes, there would be more focus on competency-based teaching, experiential learning, and of course, not emphasizing on cramming and rote learning. The flexibility of the subjects, emphasis on vocational skills, from which classes are the vocational skills going to start on, right? And how these are going to help you. Right? How much emphasis on academic? Yes, girl, stand up. Go here. Get up. Move. Move. What do you want? What do you want? please get up and ask. You have a doubt, ask me. He is not a teacher. First, you will decide who is the teacher and who you have to ask. Sare apne aap mein teachers bane rehta hai, kisi ko kuch nahi hai. इतना एटीट्यूड हम लोगों को प्रॉब्लम हो गया, घर में बैठ के पैम्पर हो गए हम लोग. गेट अप, कम अप हियर. So here you will write down, yes, when I talk about the curriculum changes, I want you to talk about the academic changes, the co-curricular changes, right? About art integrated projects, which are going to be there, about vocational studies, right? Okay. And what could be the change in the exam pattern, how projects are going to be an important part of the curriculum, right? About the flexibility of the subjects also. And yes, of course, if these changes are in 11th and 12th, these changes are going to be introduced right from the, you can say, classes 6 onwards. We talk about the vocational studies and everything. Okay, right? Then what are the benefits of these? How it helps the child to prepare for the future, right? And yes, already the needs of the child, it could be identified, the skills could be identified, and it is not necessary everybody has to go into academics, right? Yes, and of course, as the need of the hour is that we should have skills, we should have, you know, some kind of expertise which will help us survive, right? Yeah, then of course, how is it going to be implemented? What could be the problems in its implementation? So it might be implemented, yeah, we talk about the urban areas, how is it this change going to reach the rural areas, okay? That how there is going to be an exchange, how people are going to go over there to give vocational training, how you'll have like this in-house training, right? So there are going to be bagless days also when children would, you know, focus on the vocational skills, right? So these are the implementation and how they are going to be carried about. And of course, yes, the conclusion that overall how this change, it is going to affect the future of the children, right? So yes, your exams would be there. But the pattern of teaching, the pattern of preparing for that would change. And apart from your academics, more emphasis would also be there on all-round development, acquiring a skill, right? That is the most important thing, right? And yes, so other activities and other things which are there. So this would be in your report part, okay? Fine. And when you write your acknowledgement there on that page, also only you will write, you can write down your, or you can make a front page here, which has something like this, you know. Right, so your English project file, yours is report writing, submitted by, submitted to, right? This is always there, the front page, right? Then you can see here, right? So he has put the certificate over here, okay, fine. Then he's put the acknowledgement over here. He's not necessarily put in the sequence order, but at least everything is done. Then the index is here. Fine. Then yes, here all is the article, which is there, or the report that is given. Okay. Right. So if yours was, and in the end, when I write my report, whenever we do any project, any kind of work, apart from acknowledgement is, yes, you are there acknowledging the contribution or the guidance and the supports here. In this time and age when everything is at our fingertips, we are there using the internet, we barely do our own research work. So there is something called as the bibliography. That is, where have I taken, what are my sources? Okay, right? So this would be a part of the report itself. Is this clear now? Any doubts? So will you be able to complete by 30th? No. So you want a little more time? So 15th November is okay? 15th November is fine. Please keep a target. Silence, please. No. Big class here, listen. You're going to have your PT3 in December. Before that, I want this submitted. Fine. And by 15, after that, you want to focus on your studies or not? You're going to keep on completing this. So 15th November is okay?
Yes.
Done? Very nice. See, class 12th had to do these in a couple of days only, although we had announced earlier. And we have announced this project well in advance. We have given you time to collect your data. We have given you time to read about this material. Have you or haven't you? So I get a few yeses here. Very few people have done that. Okay? Right? Any doubts? Any doubts, anyone? No doubts? So I would say, you know, like, because the curriculum changes for 11th and 12th are not so much, right? You can talk about 11th to 12th, or you can talk about 6th to 12th. And there's always an and, very rarely an or, okay? Yeah, so this is what you have to focus on. Okay, now let's come to our chapter. I want you to open to page 28, please. Open to page 28 of your book, Albert Einstein at School. So we have started reading this chapter, and here, what was it? Please manage a book, all of you. And do not come to the class like this. But you're in class 11th now. More than half of the year is over. Let us be a little sensible. Can we be sensible? Can we be responsible? Yes. Right? Now, what was Albert Einstein's problem? He did not like going to school, because what was it that he had to do in school? He had to learn facts, right? He had to learn things, and he was not happy learning that. Okay? And according to him, yes, Aditya, silence. And according to him, the kind of education which was happening in school, he was not happy with that. He thought learning facts and gathering information is not learning, right? He would rather find out things, right? That is why he liked science. He liked to study about that, but not enough science was taught. He liked maths, and his teacher appreciated his intelligence and said, I've already taught you all the maths that I can teach, isn't it? Right? So here, Albert Einstein was not happy. He was not happy in school. He was not happy at home. What was happening at home? Rajit, please, quiet now. What about at home? Why was he unhappy over there? There was violence, right? The landlady there, a lot of noise, a lot of disturbance. He could not find peace. And once again here, it is very, very important to be at peace with yourself, to be at peace with your surroundings. If you really want to be happy, it's not that, you know, like here, surrounding, it is the environment where you are working, or the environment where you are studying, or the environment where you are living, right? So if you are not comfortable over there, it is not going to promote your learning. It is not going to make you peaceful or calm, okay? Right? So that is why we end up becoming very irritated. We end up feeling stressed, okay? So it happened then also. See, and Albert Einstein, we know him as a person of a remarkable, intelligence, right? And he felt that he wanted to learn more. And what was his school environment doing? It was stifling. It was, you know, like making him feel suffocated, as if he could not grow, as if he could not learn more, right? So as a result of that, what did he think? He felt that if you're stressed day in and day out, so there comes a time when you feel as if your head is going to burst. Yes, right? So when you are not at peace with yourself, you're having a stress day in and day out. So he was very uncomfortable, and he decided, if I go to school one more day, I am going to have a nervous breakdown. Although that's a very big term to use, but that is what he thought. Then he thought the best way would be, like you people do, when you want to leave for many days, you say, okay, the doctor told me that I have to rest. So he decided that let me meet a doctor who can give me a medical certificate and say that if he keeps on going to school, he might have a nervous breakdown. But once again, the question arises, he does not have so much of money. His father barely is able to support his education. That is why he's not living where the other boys are living. He's living in a separate house, right? And so he's wondering that how is he going to raise that money, the fee for the doctor. He has only one friend who is at Uri. And Uri tells him that, yes, I know one doctor, okay? And he's just qualified as a doctor, and maybe you might be his first patient. Now, his cousin, right, Deepak? You can talk to him later. Please, you people are there sensible enough. And if I have to keep on telling you, keep quiet, I think so, then you should go to class 5 and 6. Right? You're big enough to understand how to sit in the classroom. You know how to sit in the classroom? Yes, we do. So he had, you know, like his cousin told him that, see, it's so easy to pass the exams. What was the tip that she gave for passing the exam? That you just have to learn everything and rewrite it all during the exam and you'll pass, right? So in a way, she has summarized the whole concept of education. Do we need to change this? Yes. What should be learning like? What should be learning like? Or how should we learn? Cramming things? Then understanding? Then how do we know I've understood this thing? Practically applying that knowledge? Yes, giving a situation or giving a question as such. Ananya is really applying her knowledge of talking. Or she's so good, you know, is happy with her skill of talking so much. It's good to talk, but there's a time and place for talking. And how many times have I paused in between to make you people realize you're talking, you're not behaving well? Next, it's Krish Kundra's turn and the person next to him. Another Krish? Both Krish? So Krish, Krish, isn't it? Yes. One Krish, two Krish. So both Krish here, keep quiet. Fine. Yeah, okay. You don't have to repeat everything. Raghav, I still have not got your video of your speaking skills. It's got stuck in the way somewhere. Yeah. Right? I hope by next year, by the time you complete your 12th class. So, right. So, when we look at it, there is a big need to change the examination system. Right? If a child is not happy going to school, we really need to look into that matter. If a child is not happy learning or does not want to cram things so that he can pass the exam, then we need to change things. And sadly enough, I think so, right from Einstein's time till today, nothing has changed. So it's time here. That is why we're talking about this. So these changes are brought about. I think so, learning is going to be more of student-based than teacher-based. The onus lies on you. You learn as and how you want to learn. Okay? So that is going to be a very important change here. So let's see. Yes, page 28. I can't imagine a doctor saying that, said Yuri. Saying what? Saying what? That he's had a nervous breakdown. I must try, said Albert, to find a doctor who specializes in nerves. Bachche, please keep quiet. So I must try to find a doctor who specializes in nerves. There are plenty of them, Yuri told him. He hesitated for a moment and then added rather reluctantly, I'll ask some of the students if they know one, if you like. So he said, I can talk to my friends if they know a doctor, right? Will you? Oh, thank you, Yuri. Albert's eyes were shining. Wait a moment. I haven't found one yet. Oh, but you will. So Albert is very happy with the thought that, he's going to find a doctor for me. And who's going to say that I should not go to school, right? I need a break. Otherwise, I might have a nervous breakdown. Oh, but you will. And if I do, I don't know if he'll be willing to help you. He will, declared Albert. I'm going to have a real nervous breakdown to make it easier for him. So he says, by the time you find a doctor, I think so I'm going to have a real nervous breakdown. Then you won't have to give me a fake certificate. He laughed merrily. I've never seen you looking less nervous, remarked Yuri. A day or two at school will soon put that right, Albert assured him. So he says, right now you're looking very happy, you're looking very good to me. But he says, wait, let me go to school for 1 or 2 days and I'll be in a very nervous state again. Certainly he had lost his high spirits when Yuri saw him next. So when Yuri met him again, so he was not so happy as he was the last time they had met. I can't stand it any longer, he said. I really shall have a nervous breakdown that will satisfy any doctor. I can't stand it any longer. Stand what? It here is going to school. Yes, very nice. And he says, I'll have a really nice nervous breakdown and the doctor will be happy to see that. Keep it up then, said Yuri. I found a doctor for you. You have? Albert's face lit up. Oh, good. When can I see him? I have an appointment for you for tomorrow morning. Yuri said, here's the address. He handed Albert a piece of paper. Dr. Ernst Weil, is he a specialist in nervous troubles? Asked Albert. Not exactly, Yuri admitted. As a matter of fact, he only qualified as a doctor last week. You may even be his first patient. So he's there, he's just completed his studies and you're going to be his first patient. You knew him as a student then? I've known Ernst for years. Yuri hesitated for a few moments. He's not a fool, he warned Albert. That don't try to fool him. Be very honest with him. So, right, he might be a young doctor, a new doctor, but he's very smart. He'll recognize immediately that you're trying to fool him. What do you mean? Don't try to pull the wool over his eyes. Don't try to cheat him. Don't try to lie to him. Don't try to make a fool of him. That's all. Be frank with him, but don't pretend you've got what you haven't. So don't pretend to act like a patient who has had a nervous breakdown. You haven't. Not that you deceived anyone. Yuri added, you're the world's worst liar. That you can't cheat anybody because you don't know how to lie. You're so bad at lying. Albert spent the next day wondering what to tell the doctor. When the time arrived for his appointment, he had worried over it so much that he was really quite nervous. So early he wasn't, but then he's wondering, oh my God, what if I'm not able to convince the doctor? What if he doesn't give me the certificate? And he worried so much. Sometimes overthinking creates a lot of problems. So he got so nervous, and he was actually very nervous when he had to go to meet the doctor. Is it clear till here, Mansi? Is it clear? Himanshu, are you listening? No? Himanshu just sits there with a nice smiling face and he thinks I can understand everything. What is happening? Which page are we on? You haven't even opened that page. Which page are we on? He's on a different level altogether. Himanshu, we're doing page 30. I don't really know how to describe my trouble. Dr. Weed, he began in my book, it is 29. I'm going to say that only. Don't try, said the young doctor with a friendly smile. Yuri has already given me a history of the case. So he says, don't try to tell me. Yes, class. And Yuri has already explained your problem to me, so I know. Yeah? Oh, what did he say? Only that you want me to think you have had a nervous breakdown and say that you mustn't go back to that school. Oh dear, Albert's face fell. He shouldn't have told you that. Why not? Isn't it true then? Yes, that's the trouble. Now you say there's nothing wrong with me and you tell me to go back to school. So he shouldn't have told you. You should have told me that I don't have to go to school. So he's already told me, about myself. Don't be too sure of that, said the doctor. As a matter of fact, I am pretty sure you are in a nervous state about that school. So places where we are unhappy, where we don't feel comfortable, so we really don't want to go there, right? So this is, and it's not necessarily about school. It could be home. It could be somebody else's house, right? It could be any place that makes you feel uncomfortable, right? You don't want to go there. So here also he's saying, you're like, see, talking about the school is there making you nervous. But I haven't told you anything about it, said Albert, wide-eyed. How can you know that? Because you wouldn't have come to see me about this if you hadn't been pretty close to a nervous breakdown. That's why. Now, said the doctor briskly, if I certify that you have had a nervous breakdown and must stay away from school for a while, what will you do? So supposing I give you the certificate, supposing I say that, yes, you don't have to go to school. Then what will you do? What are you going to do?